Number three, I also want to congratulate Honorable Lillian Mongoi, the chairperson for tourism, together with the committee members who took time, incorporated us in the discussion of this matter. I'm not a member of tourism, Mr. Speaker, but I saw it fit that I should appear in all the sessions here in the chambers, just to make sure that I understand what exactly happened and what I saw, Mr. Speaker, through this committee. As they say, we come a vindo, we come a drama. Mr. Speaker, I've been here in these chambers where members have been invited from the executive side, especially the ones that have been largely mentioned in this report, to come and testify what exactly happened. And what I saw, Mr. Speaker, is what we call the utadu attitude. Utadu what? That is the kind of attitude. Like, what is the worst thing that you can do for me? You know, I have done this, and there's nothing you can do. We saw the attitude being demonstrated here in these chambers. A respectful house, Mr. Speaker, which has been constituted by the Constitution of Kenya 2010. And what I can say, Mr. Speaker, if the governor, His Excellency Andrew Wabine Wakuja, is working with such kind of individuals, then I really pity him. If he's not careful, he's going to be a one-term governor, just like his predecessors. Because what was demonstrated here, Mr. Speaker, is very sad. Very sad indeed. I'm worried that even some members, when they make comments here, saying that they don't want to be involved, you know, it sounds like it's a joke. But Speaker, this is not a laughing matter. This county has suffered the worst ever since devolution was brought into inception, Mr. Speaker. And again, Mr. Speaker, if there is anything I hate in life, is what we call pretense, or hypocrisy, or backstabbing, people who are not loyal to you. And clearly, Mr. Speaker, those officers are not loyal to His Excellency the Governor. I stand here praying every day and asking Honorable Wadimi that he shall give him the grace of understanding and knowing who is the right person or who is a true person to him. And Mr. Speaker, if there is a member here today who feels that whatever we are deliberating here is like we are withholding the governor, you are also not loyal to the governor. You are a backstabber. You are not being loyal to the governor. Let's be very honest with one another. What you are trying to do, you are just covering some con men and women working in our county offices. Mr. Speaker, the system of pajamas that we have experienced in the last regime, we don't want to be repeated in the third regime where Dorcas Luhu was elected as a member of Wrong Ward to come and represent the wrong people. I don't want to be involved. And I'm happy that I was not invited to go to, I don't know, that place where Mheshimiwa Kimbui says that he can afford to take his wife and his children. I don't want to be invited in such kind of business, Mr. Speaker. I am a sober-minded woman. I am a woman of integrity. I was raised well by my father and my mother. And I'm here to say that anything to do with corruption in this county, I will not stand with my brothers and sisters. Let us not allow this kind of attitude again. Mr. Speaker, this county is in the darkest pit that you can, you don't know how to enroot it from inside there. It's so sad, Mr. Speaker, that people have an attitude that they want to be employed in the county government or government institutions and they want to make money, not in Taita Taveta County, where Dorcas Luhu is serving as an elected MCS. And again, Mr. Speaker, there was also another communication where female MCS were invited to go to Voi Wildlife, I don't know, Voi Safari Lodge, together with the spouses of the male MCS. Mr. Speaker, with all due respect, there is no single day a wife of an elected member will come to the floor and voices her voice in regards to any development in this county, apart from the members that were elected or nominated constitutionally. Equally, Mr. Speaker, I'm expecting that as female MCS, our husbands also need to be invited in such kind of forums. You cannot start dividing us here because you feel that the spouses will come, you know, they sit with us as the female MCS, and our husbands are left us. They are also spouses, Mr. Speaker, so they should be invited. And I have no apologies to that. Mr. Speaker, it is very wrong. It is very, very wrong to make someone his wife to come and start bowing down to you. Because what those women are going to be told, maybe they're supposed to be incited and told, you know, those male members, as you see in the chambers, they do ABCD. It happened in the last regime, Mr. Speaker. And I'm privy to that information. And then we'll start coming here, I'll start be looking at Mheshimiwa Nzura, he will feel like maybe I'm the one who was saying things that are not true to the wife. You know, I'll start calling the wife, maybe we're discussing other matters. But because such kind of meetings, Mr. Speaker, should be discouraged. Because we have the mandate to come to the floor and debate, or rather deliberate on matters that are related to this county, and not our spouses, Mr. Speaker. That is being disrespectful. Mr. Speaker, as I was going through the reports over the weekend, and today as it has been tabled, the PFM Act, the Public Procurement and Disposal Act, the Constitution of Kenya, the County Government Act, and the Standing Orders of Taita Taveta County have been ignored to the letter. I have, you know, someone said, show me your friends and I'll tell you your character. Mr. Speaker, it is sad that Governor is a serious mathematician. He studied mathematics, he has worked, he has a broad experience in banking. And then he has an officer working in his office with no papers. This is how we find quacks in hospitals. This is how babies are disappearing in hospitals. Because how are you, how is the recruitment process done in this county? While we have these documents, Mr. Speaker, that I was served before when I was sworn in. This is the Constitution of Kenya. This is the County Government Act. Because as you do that such kind of appointment, Mr. Speaker, having a legal person on board as a county attorney, I'm even doubting his intelligence for the first time. You cannot even advise the governor on recruiting the right people for purposes of making sure that we get the proper services that is required legally and rightfully, Mr. Speaker. Then look at the way transactions were done. This officer by the name Thomas Njuma, doing very huge inquests directly to his account. Shame on him. Shameless man. Shame on him again. Mr. Speaker, this is not a county where you just walk in and walk out as if you're walking in a toilet. This is a county government which is constituted in the law. You don't just do things because you feel you're very close to the governor, you're untouchable. That is the kind of attitude which was in the last regime, where members would summon some officials here and they would not come. And they started the games by telling us, this matter is in the ESCC, you know, you cannot investigate. Go to hell. Go to hell, man. Unless it was in a court of law, I would respect that. Mr. Speaker, I am so much ashamed. I don't even want to imagine that if someone asked me, do you come from Taita Taveta County? Mr. Speaker, I would say no. Until when good things are spoken about Taita Taveta County, maybe I can say, okay, yeah, it's true. I come from Taita Taveta County. But, Mr. Speaker, a whole county officer, you're just an advisor. You're not even in the establishment. Mr. Speaker, we have an acting CCM under tourism. Mr. Speaker, please don't cut me off, Mr. Speaker.
Minutes to go.
How many minutes, Mr. Speaker?
Minutes.
Okay. I am a real presenter for profession. Mr. Speaker, Thomas Njuma is a partisan staff to the office of the governor. Why was he running the show and the CCM in charge of that docket should be the one running the show? Where did he get that authority from? Shumabadime has to look into this issue very keenly and very broadly to make sure that, Mr. Speaker, that such kind of things do not happen. And if we will not follow our advice today, I am sorry that if 2027 comes, Mr. Speaker, I don't want to go home now. Mr. Speaker, I need to be here because I have other ambitions in the near future. I don't want to go home now. I might not be getting a lot of money, but I'm contented with what the government is giving me. And if this is how Mheshimiwa Mwadime would want to work with his people, then he should count himself out in 2027. And this one I tell you from the deepest part of my heart, because he has been my MP for 10 years, that what is happening today, Mr. Speaker, I am very much disappointed. Otherwise, I want to wish those who are traveling to Kulakum a safe journey, safe drive, go well. And if there is anyone here, Mr. Speaker, who wants to abstain or wants to say no to this report, you are simply a sellout. You are a sellout. And you should not be in this only premises from onset. Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I submit.